just wanna praise you
forever. Come on.
Forever
and ever.
And ever.
And ever.
And ever.
Israel say it again, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, when men rose up against us, then they would have swallowed us up quickly. When their wrath was kindled against us, then the waters had overwhelmed us, the stream had gone over our soul, then the proud waters had gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord who had not given us as prey to their teeth. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken and we are escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. My question to you this morning is, for a subject, do you really remember? Find that David wrote the psalm on the occasion of celebrating a great deliverance from God, amen, brought to him and his people because of a very threatening danger. Anybody in here ever been in danger? Amen. We're not sure, for instance, if it was a danger from outside, a foreign invasion, or if it was a danger from within, but if we live long enough, you'll find out that you can get attacked from folks outside. And here it is, mental health awareness. We can get attacked from within. Amen. We can get attacked from within our households, our circle of so-called friends. Invasion and then attacks, danger, threats come from all around. Amen. But understand, whatever the threat was, they found deliverance through God. Amen. God found the way to make an escape. Anybody ever been threatened and realized after it was over with that God had already shown you the out? It was just whether or not you decided to take the exit or not. Amen. God always gives you an out because God is always present. It's whether or not you acknowledge his presence or not. When you're inside of a jam, God is never going to leave you nor forsake you. For him to do that makes him a liar. So even in the mix of your deepest and darkest moment, God is still trying to let you know that if you can recognize that one flicker of light, darkness has to leave. So he is careful to recognize that God's presence was there. So he gives glory to God and takes no credit for that deliverance. Amen. In the natural, we have a tendency to take credit when God has shown up and shown out. You know, I pulled myself up by my bootstraps, or, you know, I was able to do. You weren't able to do a thing. You can't even wake yourself up in the morning. You can set your alarm clock 50 times and not even be awakened by that technology. But God in his benevolence sends angels, touches us, wakes us up, and blesses us with new mercies. Not the same old tired mercies, but new mercies. So we have no opportunity to take credit for anything that God does. So David, first and foremost, gives credit. And he says, if it had not been. Do y'all remember when our forefathers used to remind us, if it had not been for God on my side, where would I be? See, we've gotten, can we make it plain? We've gotten to the point where we're comfortable. We have nice clothes, but my grandmama had a few dresses, and she washed her stockings out and wrung them and hung them up so they would be ready for church, amen? But now you get a run in your stocking, you run to CVS. You forgot a little something. So the brothers may have only had one suit or maybe one good shirt and one tie, but they came to church ready to praise God. We got all this stuff in the closet, but we've forgotten. And they didn't have all these zeros and commas in their bank account, but their nickels and dimes built houses all over the kingdom. Y'all don't remember. Because before we had Pharaoh's favor, we knew we had favor in God. If it had not been for God on our side, where would we be? Talking about, man, you don't know what you're talking about. You're too young to be talking like that. I said, at the feet of my elders and I listened. You may not have had steak and potatoes, but you was happy for that milk and cornbread. You pull up the sanctuaries nowadays and the parking lot is full, but the sanctuary is empty. Folk walk the church, folk packed in the cars. Now it's five people leaving the same house in five different cars. We've forgotten. We've forgotten what God has done for us. But before folk would even want to fellowship with us, we had to commune with God, sometimes even in secrecy. We've forgotten. But David remembers that in the midst of danger, in the midst of threats, if it had not been for God on my side, it felt so good that he told the people again, you got to say it again, if it had not been for God on our side, where would we be? So he understands this and he magnifies the greatness of the danger that they were in and of the ruin that they were on the brink of. Recognize your first point. Think about how great the danger you're in. Y'all remember when we were little, they had Batman that came on. And it was always a cliffhanger because Batman always got captured. Am I the only one that used to watch that? You know, how many of y'all remember that? You know, and you knew he was gonna escape, but you were scared because how did the Joker capture him this way? And he's inside this thing and ain't no way in the world he gonna get out today. That's how it is with us spiritually. We're in these dangerous situations. Has anybody ever been in such a situation where you thought to yourself, there's no way in the world? Be honest, because in the moment you weren't looking at it in the supernatural, you were looking at it in the natural. Have you ever, shame the devil, tell the truth, been in a situation where you looked at the circumstances and said, there's no way that I'm getting out of this? Anybody? There's no way. The doctor said that it can't be fixed. You say, no way. The bills then poured in and you look at your money and it's so funny that you can't laugh. You say, there's no way. Your children not acting right. You say, there's no way. Hell on the job. And that's not a cuss word, because sometimes when the enemy is in the presence, that's all that's there is hell. Amen. And you're saying, there's no way that I can go in here and do these 8 hours. But lo and behold, God puts you in a bad situation to let you know just how bad God is. I'm gonna say that again. God puts you in a bad situation to let you know just how bad God is. See, the enemy don't you have forgotten how bold the enemy is? If someone who has communed with God himself, someone so beautiful that he had access to God, was bold enough to challenge God himself. What do you think he cares about challenging you? If the same individual is so bold to challenge the Son of God in the midst of his preparation for ministry, what do you think he cares about challenging you? Your little storms, your little circumstances are nothing to him. But in the time being, you think it's everything. And God is saying, you have forgotten, you have forgotten, you have forgotten. I'm the same God that brought you out of the last storm. I'm the same God that brought you out of the last valley. I'm the same God that when you were celebrating, put you on the pinnacle of the mountaintop, but yet you forget. So then David decides to do this. He gives God the glory for their escape. Because you raised your hand and said that you were in a situation where you thought you could not get out of that bad situation, but God showed up and showed out, right? Have you ever been in a situation where God showed up and you knew that there was no other way that you got out of it other than God? Maybe it's just me, but I've been in some situations, and mostly because of my own doing or my lack of doing, and I had nobody else to call on but God. And when God decided to not just show up, because he was already there, but reveal himself, manifest himself, when God decided to shift the environment, I had no other choice but to recognize that it was God on my side. You should be happy that God is on your side, because everybody ain't on your side. Everybody that smile at you don't love you. I'm gonna say that again. Everybody that smile at you don't love you. Everybody that hug you don't care for you. Judas hugged and kissed Jesus and sold him out, amen. Be careful who hugging and kissing you, amen. Be careful who's breaking bread with you. Be careful who's sitting at the table with you. Be careful who's trying to roll with you. Everybody that you rolling with ain't for you. But it's okay, because when God is on your side, I don't care. You can't touch me. You can't touch me. So he starts singing these songs because he recognizes that the malice of men, which can bring the ruin of yourself. Understand how quickly God works. Do you know that you're really only a breath away, a step away, a hand movement away, a thought away from the enemy having his way in your life? But God in his swiftness, God in his strength, God in his, here it is, power is able to shift things. So right when the, here's the illustration, right when the enemy thinks he's about to grab you, God scoops you up. Have you ever seen somebody, a child is about to fall and a parent scoops them up before danger? Have you ever seen somebody snatch somebody out of the clutches of death? And God shows up and gives you safety. Why? Because he's on your side. Have you forgotten? But don't. You're saying, well, I'm in a bad situation. God didn't come swift me up before I got in the situation. Read the scripture. It says you were in the snare. You're in the snare. Anybody here in the snare right now? You're in a bad situation. See, we read over the scriptures and we don't dive into them. So you're in the snare. So you've been caught. But God rips the snare apart. See, sometimes God has to sit you down, let you be caught, so you can recognize that it ain't your power, it's God's power. See, if you could get out of the snare yourself, you wouldn't be on your knees praying to God. If you could get out of the snare yourself, you wouldn't praise God. If you could get out of the snare yourself, you wouldn't glorify God. But sometimes God puts you down so that you can recognize who God is. God doesn't have a desire to hurt you, but he has a desire for you to recognize who butters your bread. He wants you to recognize who is all powerful in all of this that is going on. So therefore, he says, I can break the snare and even take you out of the teeth of those who think that they have you. Amen. Now, let's stay on that for a minute. Some of y'all are more concerned with the teeth than the rest of the mouth. Y'all don't catch what I'm saying. Sometimes while y'all worried about somebody biting, might want to worry about that tongue. Amen. See, when God is on your side too, it doesn't matter what people say about you. It doesn't matter what people think about you. Because guess what? Everybody ain't going to like you. Everybody ain't going to love you. And you can save their life and they still won't have anything good to say about you. But again, when God is on your side. So my brothers and sisters,
like a lamb out of the very jaws of the beast of prey. God has not given us as prey to the teeth of those who come after us. Amen. God has told us that if our hearts are right and if we have the heart to follow God, God will be able to touch us and we can find trust in God if we remember who He is. See, before we had these cushioned pews and air conditioning, we had to roll up the windows, right? Before stained glass windows and all that, we had to let some air blow in because we didn't have all these amenities. We didn't have all these things, but we remembered that no matter what, God put a roof over our head. No matter what, God put food on our table. No matter how ragged it was, God put clothes on our back. I remember my parents telling me that their shoes would run out and they would take the shoes and put a piece of cardboard down in the shoe so that they can make it to school. Y'all don't know anything about that down here. Maybe that was just upstate. But understand what was going on. No matter what, they knew that God was on their side. Amen. So all I'm saying is, have you remembered who God is? Have you remembered what God is able to do? The young people saying, my brothers and sisters, the Lord is my light and my salvation. If you in the darkness, do you remember that God is your light and your salvation? If you're in the darkness and God is your light and your salvation, then the light has conquered the darkness. Do you remember? Do you remember when you met God? You were broken down. You were tore up from the floor up. But God met you right where you were and said, guess what? You're mine. They can't have you. The enemy can't have you. Have you forgotten what God has promised you? God promised that He would never leave you nor forsake you. Though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Do you understand that you're walking through the valley? That you're not camped out in the valley? That God is right there with you? Have you forgotten that the storm that you're in now is not your first storm? It's not going to be your last storm. But who was there at your first storm? Jesus. Who's in your storm right now with you? Jesus. Who'll be in there with your storm tomorrow? Jesus. Have you forgotten the same God that took care of mama? The same God that took care of grandmama? The same God that took care of great-grandmama? It's the same God that'll take care of you. The same God that'll take care of your child. The same God that'll take care of your grandchild. Have you forgotten that it's the same God that showed up on yesterday? It's the same God that'll show up today. The same God that'll show up tomorrow. The light and my salvation. Whom, what shall I fear? Quit being fearful of man. It's the same God that protected you yesterday. The same God that will protect you today. The same God that will protect you tomorrow. Who will you put your trust in? Somebody say Jesus. Somebody say Jesus. This will get you shouting right here. Early one morning, some sisters got up to have their own memorial day. They went to a tomb to try and go and take care of a man named Jesus. But guess what? When they went to go see the fallen soldier that left the church militant to the church triumphant, they realized when they got to the tomb that he wasn't fallen. He wasn't fallen. He wasn't fallen. He was risen with all power in his hands. That's why you should remember it's the same God that is not fallen and the same God that can keep you from falling. And his name is Jesus.
Make some noise. Make some noise. Everybody. Come on, let's rock. Everybody. Come on, put your hands out there. Make some noise. Hype it up.
Hold on, my brother.
guess what?
The best
is yet, to come. Say it again.
The best.
The best is yet.
You ain't seen nothing.
Everybody
yet.
See that.